here today bringing you all a brand new car comparison. Today I'm going to be comparing the 2016 VW Polo Trendline and the 2016 Ford Fiesta Baseline. Both of these cars are the cheapest and the most basic models of these two brands, the VW Polo and the Ford Fiesta. So I'm going to roll up the clips and enjoy the video. Go through the specs of the VW Polo. This car has a 1.4 four-cylinder engine which produces 74 brake horsepower, which is a good amount for this car, but since it's front-wheel drive it feels a bit faster because it doesn't spin. Now this car goes to 0 to 100 kilometers in 10.9 seconds, which is extremely slow, and it has a top speed of 182 kilometers an hour or 113 miles an hour. This car weighs 1.1 tons or 2,400 pounds, and it's very economical. It's on the city it averages about 6.5 liters per 100 kilometers, and on the highway it averages about 5.3 liters per 100 kilometers, which is very, very economical for a four-cylinder engine. Then this car only comes in a 5-speed manual, no automatic, and the price starts at 117,000 rand and it goes up to 201,000 rand at the dealer for a second-hand 2016, or in America $7,000 or $12,000. It's like a good car. It's like, for the price, you do get lots of extras. So now let's go through the specs of this Ford Fiesta. This Ford Fiesta has a 1.6 four-cylinder engine, or you can also have a three-cylinder engine. This one is a three-cylinder engine because it has three cylinders. You can see it, it's very visual, it's very obvious. It produces 120 brake horsepower. That's a lot of brake horsepower. Then It's front wheel drive like the Polo. It weighs just like under 2,500 pounds or 1.2 tons. Then it's not that economical compared to this car. This car is 7.2 liters per 100 kilometers on the city, and on the highway it averages about 6.4 liters per 100 kilometers, which it does drink a bit more fuel compared to this car. So you're going to be saving 1 liter per 100 kilometers with this car. Economical. Now this car also comes in a 5-speed manual, no automatics, and it is much more expensive compared to this car. This car can start up to like 160,000 rand, and it can go up to 240,000 rand from the dealer, which is a lot more expensive compared to this car. And we're going to see if the extra money is worth, because this car looks very nice, and this also looks very nice from the Aston Martin grille. Let me know down in the comment section below which one you prefer, the Polo or the Fiesta. So this is the back of these two cars. As you see, they do have their different type of characters. This is a German car, so it looks more sporty and it has better quality. And this is an American car. See, American cars aren't as good quality, like build quality, compared to the German rivals. So which one do you prefer at the back? I kind of like the Polo because it has more body lines and everything, but I like how this is like curved. It's kind of nice. So I'm going to open the boots or the trunks of these two cars, and we're going to see how big these boots are, because these two cars are very good student cars or first cars. So as you see, I'm going to put them up on the screen. These boots are a very good size. I think they're the same size. Yeah, they're the same size. I think the Polos is a little bit bigger than that, but they're the same size. You can fit many things in there, because you know, when you're a student or a young driver, you go to school or college, and you want to put some things in there, or you can go to parties, you know. So this is the boots of these two cars. They do look very nice. This car doesn't have LED lights, but it's something like LED lights, which look kind of cool. This one doesn't have LED lights, but this is a better quality light than this car. But I'm not going to be biased towards the Polo, because I'm not. These two cars are very nice cars. It's all on preference. So I'm going to move on to the interior of these two cars. Interior of the Polo, because I'm in the Polo. And I've reviewed many Polos in my channel. If you have watched all of them, then this is going to be a boring review. But as you see, this is a very nice interior. Since it's the baseline, it does have the trend line. It does have the more basic steering wheel, and it does feel a bit cheap, I have to admit. So I'm going to start it up, and then we're going to hear the sound isolation of this car. As you hear, it is very, very quiet in here. It's extremely quiet. I think it's important for like a student or someone, for it to be quiet, because they like to listen to music. Talking about music, this car has Bluetooth, aux, USB, and an SD card, which is really cool. And then you also have many other things. You have your radio. And then you also have your vehicle status, which is also another very cool feature. You have your phone, then your system settings is right over here. And Polos, VW, has very good sound systems for the price you pay. You do get like, this is not a very cheap dashboard. This is not plastic, this is soft touch. But you do like get a little bit cheaper steering wheel, but you do get a very good sound system. This car, let me just turn on the air conditioning, because it's very hot right now. Then this is the tour. If you want to see a full review of this, you should go watch the VW Polo TDI review, because I reviewed everything over here what it does and everything. So now you do get your air conditioning, get this very, very nice manual knobs. Then you do have your 5-speed manual gearbox, which is right over there. Then handbrake, manual handbrake. Then this is not working. And now this is it. As you see when I rev it, let me just turn on the AC. When I rev it, hear how quiet it is. It does have a soft limiter there, which kind of sucks. Look at it. It like peaks out at like 2000 RPM. Then you do have two cup holders. Then you only have electric windows in the front, like the Ford. This is not plastic like the this is not plastic like the Ford. This is a type of metal. Shows the quality. You have that central locking. And then you have manual mirrors. Doesn't really bother me. And you have your light switch there. I've been using this since like the Golf 3, Golf 4. Even the Polos, like they've been using that for a long time. And this is the passenger door, the door cover. Speakers is right over there. And what else do I have to say? You do have a lot of storage there. You can turn, you can, your steering wheel can go up and down, and up and down. And this car has 5 cup holders. How cool is that? One over there, one over there, two over there, and one over there. Yeah, that's stuck. So you see, it's like everyone in this car gets accommodated with cup holders. So this is the front of this car, and I'm gonna now move on to the back of the car. So this is the back of this Polo, and as you see, you do have lots of space in here. As you see, you do have a very, very nice pattern. Polo's VW has always made very nice patterns for their seats. And I think it's pretty important so there can be space at the back, because you know you're gonna have friends when you're a first driver or something, and you're gonna like go out a lot with your friends. So this car can comfortably fit 5 people in here. So you just have to put the smallest person in the middle, because look at that, like a huge bump over there. And then you do have your manual mirrors over here. For the price you paid, you have a lot of extras in this car. Then you do have your, this is not plastic, which I'm surprised. This is material, not plastic. And you do have your speakers here. Then what else do I have to say about over here? You have seat belts, of course you have seat belts. And yeah, this is the interior of this Polo. So this is the view from the, like the rear passengers. This is what they see. It's a nice view actually. So I'm gonna move on to the Ford's interior right now. So this is the Ford's interior, and as you see, it's automatically a different feeling in here. One thing is that I'm sitting very low, because you cannot pull, there's no lever for you to pull up and down the seats, because that's a very stupid option, I have to admit. Then you do have this very, you have this odometer there. To be honest, for the price you pay for this car, it's just ridiculous. Like 160,000 Rand for a car that cannot lift up the seat. Then you do have this type of air conditioning. It's a very cheap feeling. Too much plastic used in here. So I'm going to quickly start this car up so you can hear the sound isolation. And as you know, you must always put the car on first, second, or reverse gear when you are parked, because you never know what will happen. You must never leave it on neutral. No, no. There we go. This is the sound isolation of the car, and it's very, very hot in here. So I'm gonna turn on the AC. I'm gonna feel how it is. Great. So now I don't think you will hear me over the AC. So this is, you do have a, let me switch it off. So you do have a little, very, very, very little screen over there, which you can easily strain your eyes at.
But if you're young, I'm not sure that will really bother you. You do have this very, very cheap feeling console. Everywhere, plastic. This is even plastic. The quality is nothing compared to the VW, the Polo. You do have your 12 volts. You have your 12 volt cigarette lighter or charger. You do have your USB. This car has 3 cup holders. 5 cup holders. But those, I don't think that really counts as a cup holder. So this is the steering wheel. You do have a lot of chrome in here. You do have buttons on the steering wheel, which that's a very nice. This steering wheel does feel a little bit more premium compared to the Polos, but the sound system of this car is nothing compared to the Polos. Like, seriously, it's nothing. You do have your cabby hole. You can turn off your airbag just like the Polo. Over there, it's for your passenger airbag, so you can show that it's off. Then you have your manual handbrake, and this is your odometer. As you see, it's not a bad odometer. As you see, you do have your fuel gauge, then your for your speed, for your revs. It's pretty cool in here. You do have for your lights, and just like the Polo, you only have electric windows for the front. You do have electric mirrors, which is a pretty cool feature. But just remember, you're gonna sacrifice these things for a bit for not a very good sound system. That's why the Polo has more manual, but it has a much better sound system. Then you have your AC vents, and let's see, you have AUX, you have USB. Let's see, how do you even control this? You see, this is very complicated because I'm sure you're gonna get used to it, but this, I don't think this car has Bluetooth. Let's see. Phone. Yeah, this car does have Bluetooth, and it does have, okay, it has Bluetooth devices, AUX, Bluetooth audio. That's pretty cool. Then this is not plastic, I kind of like that, but this is just very complicated. They had this type of complicated thing for a long time. Then what else do I have to say in the front of here? You do have a nice seat pattern, and this is the passenger door cover. This is not plastic, which I like, but this is plastic, which will break easily. Look, it's easily bending. That will break very easily. This is plastic. It's pretty good. Do you want to hear the hooter? Sounds good. So now I'm going to move on to the back of this car. So this is the interior, the back of this Ford. And you have a lot of space over here, honestly. Like, much more space compared to the Polo. That's a very big plus. You do have your manual windows. Plastic over there. This is all plastic over here. Plastic. This whole thing is plastic. There is no nice material. This whole thing is plastic. Look at that. That's plastic everywhere. Plastic, plastic. And you do have a more of a boring pattern, but who's complaining? You can buy a seat cover if you want, but they don't look that nice. You do have your seat belts, but as you see, the seat belt placement is different. The Polos has the two buckles over there. This one has, and one over there, but this one is opposite. You do have one cup holder and a nice storage area over there. Then you do have this very cheap feeling headlining compared to this one on a more expensive car. Can you believe that? Okay. You can, when you do this, you can easily get heat burn or something. Then this is it. This is it for the interior of this Ford. This is the perspective from the passenger side. As you see, it actually does look kind of nice, I have to admit. So I'm going to move on to the sides of these two cars. So this is the side of the Polo. As you see, it doesn't look like a very budget car. If you order one of these and you put it on it, it's going to make the car look very nice.
Then you do have these build caps. They're not bad, but you do have other options. Like, I think you have like 3 or 4 options, which is pretty cool. Or you can just put on another type of wheel caps. But I've seen much worse wheel caps compared to that Ford Fiesta and this one. I've seen much worse. Then this is also plastic, but the build quality, it's very sturdy, as you see. No one can steal it. No one can steal your gas, because when the car's locked, can't. But the car's unlocked. When I lock the car, which I'm going to show you now, which I need to take the key for it. Put the key right over here. Let's close it. I'm going to lock the car. Now watch. Can't steal the gas. I unlock. Done. So you see, it's, you can see they thought of that. Then this, you do have plastic door handles, but they do feel better quality, much better quality. But they've been using these door handles for like a very, 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 very long time. Like, go search up like Golf 3, you're gonna see that. Or even Polo Classic, go search that, you're gonna see the same thing. So, or Polo Player. So now this is it. This is the side of it. Let me move to the front so you can see the back of it. As you see, it does look very nice. And this is the side of these two cars. As you see, it locks automatically. I didn't unlock it, but it locked automatically. Pretty cool. Security features, very, very cool. And yeah, so this is the side of this VW Polo.
So this is the side of the Fiesta, Ford Fiesta. As you see, it looks like a normal Fiesta, but it just has ugly wheel caps. I think they're ugly. My opinion, I think they're ugly. No offense. And then you do have these plastic door handles, which can break easily because it's plastic.
Enjoyed this review, please can you smash that thumbs up button, smash the subscribe button, and turn on post notifications so you can never miss a car review, a car comparison, or another video, probably a vlog. So these two cars are very nice. It's all on preference. Me personally, I prefer the Polo. It's better quality, better sound system, and there's much more extras. But you can choose whatever you want. It's all on personal preference. Some people might like this car by its looks or the interior. Some people might like this car for its interior or the looks. Some people might not like this car. Some people might not like this car. So it's all on taste. As you see, everyone is different. No one's the same. So I can't tell you which car to buy, but this car is worth the money. This car is more worth it compared to that car. So, as I told you, thank you very much for watching. If you have stayed to this part of the video, you're the best, and I'll see you at my next video. Goodbye.